is your life feeling a little out of sequence? Mine too, so I can't help you with that. But what I can do is help you put some numbers in sequence for the GRE. Let's get to it.
We're given step one and step two in our sequence, and we're also given the third term. So finding the fourth term is easy. Add one and double it. To find the second and first term, we just gotta do the same thing in reverse. So first we half it, and then we subtract one. So the second term in our sequence is 8. Let's look into the first one. The first term in our sequence is 3. So the answer choices are 3, 8, and 38. Presto!
GRE tip on the triangle inequality. The triangle inequality says that the sum of any two sides of a triangle has to be greater than the length of the third side. So let's call our third side x. That means that 7 plus x must be bigger than 4, 4 plus x has to be bigger than 7, and 4 plus 7 has to be bigger than x. It's this middle one that tells us x has to be bigger than 3, and so the answer is A, column A is greater. For more practice problems and explanations, check out the link in our bio for a 7-day free trial. If one circle has a radius of x, the other has a diameter of 2x, all we need to do is remember that diameter equals 2 times the radius. So if that's 2x, it also has a radius of x, and these are exactly the same size circle. So column A and column B are asking for the same ratio in the same circle, and therefore, they're equal.